Okay, mic check. 1, 2, 1, 2. Okay, mic check. 1, 2, 1, 2. Cool. That seems a bit loud. For my taste. There we go. Alrighty. It's Sunday. Boom. Oh, whoops. With the line and seal of the broken, nothing stands between the Red Army and Berlin. I must really look into getting a, into a combined, you know, a combined chat bot. It's a bit of a hassle doing the chats every time. What's up, Marku? Yeah, I think this is actually my first run, but I can't be asked to change the stream title, so. Because I'm really curious. I wanna double check my. Oh, why is that playing my Twitch? There we go. Yeah, I need to double check my 360 because I'm pretty sure this is in my 360 achievements list, and yet I just have zero memory of playing this game. I mean, maybe I did play it, and I just... It just completely just did not stay in my memory at all. It's possible, you know? I have played a lot of games. There's probably other games that I've forgotten I've played. So... What's up, Master? Alright. Well, how's my controller doing? I had to charge my controller a bit. Oh, look at that. God, I love the PS3 control. That's what I hear, yeah, which makes it, you know, kind of weird why I just don't remember it, but... Maybe I just played it after, like, playing other Call of Duties and it just kind of blurred together, I don't know. Because while there are some standout Call of Duties to be sure, like if you played all of them, you know, like if you played every Call of Duty back to back, you know, they'd blur together pretty quickly. There we go, a machine gun. Much better. Not sure what I'll play after this. I might play Bulletstorm after this. Still a bit loud. I've been meaning to replay Bulletstorm for a while. And I remember really liking that game. So, what's up, Slayer? Favorite was Modern Warfare 2? Do you mean the original Modern Warfare 2? Or the remake? Because, you know, there's two games with exactly the same name. I see you're hard at work here, my friend. Ah, the original? Okay. I wonder if we're going to get a remake of Modern Warfare 3. Wow, that's my tank, so... Do we know what this year's Call of Duty is going to be? Now that I think about it. What's up, Ream? I had a dream where someone found a way to get consistent greens in NGT mission mode, but only on a mission 11, and you had to shoot dudes at the top of the mountain to get greens. Oh, man. That's how you know you're playing too much survival mode. When you start dreaming about it. I can relate. I used to dream about NG all the time, honestly. Especially when I was karma running. Used to dream about, you know, strategies all the time. And I used to think, oh man, you know, I'd wake up and think, oh, I'll have to try that, see if that works. I haven't played Black Ops 1 and 2's zombies. I played Black Ops 1's campaign, but I never played 2 and I never touched zombies. I never played Call of Duty multiplayer until Black Ops 4. Oh. Oh dear. I also usually never have dreams. Really? I dream all the time. Dude, what? I was nowhere near that car. I checked YouTube to see if it was real, and it's not. Okay, there we go. I kept that rocket launcher, didn't I? Yeah, I need to move my mic. I really must look into getting, a mic arm that can get this mic out of the way. Because no matter where I put it when I'm streaming, it's in the way of something, and it's very annoying. Well, I finished up Vanquish today too. I finished up my playthrough on that, and just mopping up some trophies before I do challenge mode. Alright. Okay. Oh, wait, no, hang on. Okay. Dude had more ammo. I should probably get rid of that rocket launcher, but... I was curious there, like, how I managed to get shot in the back. Your help is so irritating in this game. Like, they don't do anything. They constantly get in your way. And I swear these guys just keep respawning. Oh, at least I can steal his ammo. You know what? Could you stop doing that, please? Thank you. I started watching Metastasis yesterday. Colombian remake of Breaking Bad. Oh, okay. Yeah, someone's on that fucking turret again. Don't hold your breath on the blindfolded series, honestly. I will get back to it. I'm just really not in the mood to play it right now. The next, like, up until chapter 10, that run is going to be pretty fucking annoying. Chapter 10 is when you start getting back into, like, more enclosed spaces, which is where that run's a bit more manageable. But, yeah, up until that point, like, I have zero desire to go back to that at the moment.
This place reeks of nightmares and madness, but only the insane would stand against us.
Yes!
We will be killing at corpse quarters.
Oh, I didn't even know there was that. I just thought, Breaking Bad is what? When did Breaking Bad finish? Was it 2012? 2013? I don't think the helicopter's going to be that bad, you know. It's not going to be easy, but I'm not, like, super worried about the helicopter. Because on normal, you can almost one-cycle it. You know, if you get a non-wise guy helicopter. And my muscle memory will be, like, reasonably good for that. There's far more things, like, there's way worse segments of that run to worry about. Like, I think the tanks will be worse than the helicopter. Okay, I don't really want this. Oh, is it all on YouTube? Oh, okay. Last episode for... Oh, 2030. Yeah, so to... Yeah, over 10 years ago, man. Man, it doesn't seem like it, does it? I recognize this house. This house is in Blackout. I did not know that. Uh-oh, there's a lot of dudes in there. Yeah, I thought this looked familiar. Oh, so 11 years ago. Jesus. That is, I don't know, it doesn't feel like it's that old. Ooh, shit. Must have been a rocket. Was that a rocket or a grenade? I don't know. Thank you. Okay. See what I mean? How am I getting shot in the back here? I just got a damage ping from behind me. Last year's was Modern Warfare 3, right? As in the new Modern Warfare 3. My god. That guy actually killed somebody. That's pretty funny. I feel like I should probably ditch this rocket launcher, but... trying to think what the last, like, really great TV show I watched was. You know, the sort of, that would be on par with Breaking Bad. Or something similar. Oh shit. Have that back. Ah, I knew it. Yeah, I don't know. I really liked the first season of Reacher a lot. But, I won't, you know, I won't put it on par with something like that. Like, it's good, but, you know, it's not, you know, like, best TV show ever sort of thing. And Walt finds Crazy 8 on the street, and there's another random guy help him and put Crazy 8 in his car. Uh-oh. My bad. I mean, he did walk right in front of me, so... Yeah, there was a rumor last year that there wasn't going to be a Call of Duty. But I guess they just, you know, that yearly cycle is just, you know, oh shit. They just can't not do it. Because from what I heard about Modern Warfare 3, the one that came out last year, and what I saw, it was like the most thrown together, like Frankenstein of body parts game ever. And yet it still did very well. So, I guess, you know, Call of Duty really is just like, you know, FIFA or Madden is now. Like, people just don't care. Whatever the new one is, you know, their core audience will just buy it. Alright, cool. What's up, Ellen? Watch first couple episodes of Reacher and didn't enjoy it. I mean, yeah, he is. Yeah. Reacher is not a very, he's not a very nuanced character. So, that's definitely fair. No, I didn't watch The Punisher because, wasn't that only on Netflix? And say, I don't have Netflix, so. No, I didn't watch The Punisher. I did hear The Punisher's really good, though. I wonder what they're going to do with the Punisher. Like, that character. Because, you know, he's not really a... he's not really a PG-friendly character, so... Is that... Like, why aren't you guys shooting him? Can you even get, Do they even do... I've not actually looked, but can you get any Netflix stuff physical? Nah, kind of fucked there. Yeah, you see, this is the problem with modern TV. Where do you watch Peacemaker? What, you know... Right, yeah. Like, see what I mean? What the fuck are you doing? Gee, I don't know why, but like the help being incredibly useless is... I don't know why, but it's bugging me a lot more than it normally does. Because, yeah, you know, granted, you should never expect AI to be useful, but, like, these guys really are taking the piss. Like, these are putting Halo Marines to shame right now. But yeah, I've heard good things about Peacemaker. It's just, I don't want, like, I'm not invested in TV enough, you know, to have, you know, 5 or 6 different streaming services to watch it all. I'm just not, you know. So I pretty much just watch whatever's on Prime if it's good. and that's it. So, usually I just wait for stuff to come out on DVD or Blu-ray, so. The original release is HBO Max. Okay. I can recommend a free streaming site. I don't care enough, to be honest. If it's on HBO, then I should be able to get it on physical someday. What's up, Chili? No, I haven't played any of the Red Orchestra games. This is on regular. TV is pretty low on my list of pastimes, so the barrier to entry is pretty much, you know, is it on Amazon? Cool. Can I get a, you know, can I get it on a box set? Cool. If the answer is no to those questions, that's it. I was just curious to see if they'd let you do that. They do. I wonder, is there a trophy for not doing that, or? These guys didn't seem all that bothered that I did that, so. Has anyone here played Bulletstorm? Just out of curiosity. Because that'll probably be my next stream game. I've been wanting to replay that for a while. Bulletstorm's good shit. What's up, Reflect? No, I'm on normal. Going by what I've heard, I don't think I'll bother playing this game on hard, because so there's already been a few segments that even on normal that have been pretty fucking annoying. So, I don't think I'll bother with hard on this one. It just does not seem like a fun mode at all. Knowing the levels will help. That will help make it a bit less punishing, but yeah, I don't think I'll bother. If it was an easy platinum, I might. You know, but I'm good. I've got plenty of easy platinums to get, so. Okay, I was being a bit silly there. Any good Vita games to recommend? There are, but every one that I can recommend, you can just play on PS3. So, yeah, basically just recommending PS3 games. Like, Escape Plan would be one. Super Stardust Delta would be another one. Tearaway would be one. Gravity Rush would be one. But every game I just mentioned, you can get on PS3. So, you may as well just play them on PS3. Dude, get out the way! Thank you. I think higher difficulties in shooters in general over the last, like, 10 or so years has just gone completely down the pan. Because all they ever do is just, yeah, like, you know, the enemies are just, you know, aimbot and kill you in two hits, and you know your AI is terrible. They constantly just spam nades and shit at you, and like they just make it not fun. And you think, you know, that there are shooters that have highest difficulty modes that are actually fun and not just cheap, but they do take more effort to do. It's way easier to just, you know, flip the damage sliders and increase the aimbot of your enemies. He actually shot that guy, but did not kill him. That's funny. I've heard this is the worst one, to be fair. Which is saying a lot, because I've always thought Modern Warfare is... Well, I'd say that's the worst of the ones I've played. And I'm trying to think, is that... Yeah, there isn't a Call of Duty that I've played that I haven't beaten on Veteran. So, like, Modern Warfare 1 would be the worst of those. Like, there are so many segments in that game that are just such bullshit. And they're just not fun. But I think the Call of Duty games have gotten significantly easier over the years. Once you get to, like, the Xbox One era, I feel like Advanced Warfare, Infinite Warfare onwards, like Veteran mode is pretty straightforward. It's really not that hard. To the point where I started playing them on Veteran off the bat to get more achievements, because they're just so much easier. They are more fun, though, I will say that, because I say they just don't feel as cheap. In the rear. Oh, not quite. I should have let him carry on around much fucking use you lot are. And take your ammo. Whoa, that's a lot of enemies. And then they added realism as well into the new games. Like there's veteran and realism, and I think realism is just veteran with no HUD. Or is it no HUD, or is it like a disappearing HUD? I can't quite remember. I think it's no HUD. You know, one thing that doesn't help in this game as well is just how similar every fucking enemy looks to your guys. It's like, the enemies are the slightly other green dude. And in a game, you know, that's like mainly just green and brown and grey, it can be kind of tricky to tell the difference. For instance, there's a trophy in this game. I was looking them up the other day. There's a trophy in this game for dying 20 times in the same level. And in the trophy guide, it was like, yeah, don't worry about this. You'll easily get this when you play veteran. And I thought, yeah, that's not exactly the ringing endorsement, you know. Oh, shit. Oh no, they're my guys, okay. Like, the tanks aren't even killing everyone, anything. You're in tanks, bro. How useless are you? Whoops, am I dead? Well, yeah, it is, but, you know, I don't play Call of Duty for, realism. Should I kill them? Should I not kill them? Oh, well, I guess it doesn't make any difference. Hey, well, let it be known that I tried to show mercy. I tried to be merciful. You sick fuckers. You just committed a war crime. Y'all need therapy. Don't worry, I'll kill him. Honestly, this MP40 really does just shred. I don't really need anything else. Whoops. Die. Although my ammo is getting a little bit low. So. He wasn't wounded. I mean, dude, he was blatantly trying to conceal, you know, something. He was up to no good, man. I'm telling you, he would have shot us in the back. Oh, we got some more ammo from somewhere, that's nice. What's up, Zach? Did anyone play this game? Did anyone play zombies in this game? This was the first one, right? And, like, this being the best one is a pretty common opinion, from what I've seen. You guys just can't fight. Full fucking stop. Just, you're fucking useless. An NGB remake? No. Just put NGB out again. Don't remake it. They'll fuck it up. They'll add, you know, new bow controls or some shit. Whereas if they just put it out, I wouldn't mind. If they just put the game out again, I'd be like, yeah, fine. With trophies. Put it out with trophies, though. Put it out with trophies. I want trophies. I want trophies for NGB. Give me some trophies. That'll be a really easy platinum. No, I haven't tried those mods, actually. No, I haven't. I would like to, but... especially the NG2 one. I would really like to try it. I'm not that bothered about Sigma 2, like... But yeah, I would like to try the NG2 one. I mean, that's the one I mean, sorry. Okay, we're not dead. Well, yeah, I mean, Sigma is a remake. It's true. That is true. Anyone here watch any 24? I always think of 24 when I hear Kiefer Sutherland's voice. My brother got the box set for that. And I only watched the first three seasons, and after that, it's not that it got bad, it's just that the 24, like, 24 was a series that I don't think really benefited from being able to watch it, you know, all in one go. Once you watch that back to back, it's, you know, it sort of loses a bit of its. You think, oh, you know, what's going to happen next? Because you can just watch what happens next. So. It depends what they were, Slayer. Because you got to think, man. When you add things to a game like that, you know, you got to be careful what you're adding. You know, more content is not always better. Sometimes more is less. Am I supposed to be shooting these? Well, I'll soon find out if not. Although, that said, like, of all the missions they added, for the Vita release, I don't hate any of them. So... Like, not all of them are good, but... there's none that I would say are, like, outrightly abysmal. They're just ones where you think, ah, you know... it's like, the secrets of shooting missions. You think, yeah, you know... you know, you probably could have given us better missions than this, but, you know, okay, fine, they're all points at the end of the day, it's all karma, but they probably could have, you know, done something a bit better with those. But yeah, 24 is a series I keep meaning to get back to at some point. Because there's loads of seasons of it, I think. Didn't they do, like, 9 or 10 seasons of 24? Oh, dear. Ah, this doesn't overheat. I wasn't really paying attention to that. Is that... man, these take a hell of a lot of bullets. I am pressing square, thank you. Okay, well that was much easier. Is there any Call of Duty that doesn't have, you know, a turret mission? I can't think of one. I think they all have at least one, right? I think we disabled them, but they're still... oh, I had an idea for another Resident Evil 4 run today. On the original RE4. Mixed herb run I did, where you try and collect every single herb in the game. I was wondering, is it possible to do the same thing but with grenades? Could you collect every single grenade in the game? And still have enough space, you know, to keep stuff to get through the game. Because the biggest item case would hold 60 grenades, I think. If my memory's correct. And there's a lot of grenades in that game. I don't know if there's 60, but there is a lot. There's over 20 incendiaries that I can, you know, that I know of. So I think, you know, that only leaves 40 between frags and flashbangs. But it could be a fun run to try. And I haven't played OG RE4 in quite a while. I don't know what that trophy was. Hopefully it was an optional one. Yeah, that is... okay. God, was Black Ops 4 really that long ago? Really? Was it? Yeah, fucking, that was 2018, wasn't it? Shit, yeah. I loved Blackout, man. Blackout was... Oh, dude. That was so much fun. Warzone just did not... Warzone just didn't do it for me. Okay. I must have missed something there. It's really tricky to see where these bullets are actually, like, even though, I don't know, they seem to just be moving extremely slow. I mean, Fire Wheels doesn't really need upgrading, but I know what you mean. Although it can be in, I mean, technically it is in the Vita version, because in the Vita version you have like the, you know, you have a way to power up your Nimpo, and you can power up Fire Wheels. It's just in the Master Collection, the default Fire Wheels is just, you know, what upgraded Fire Wheels is. And upgraded Fire Wheels is no joke. It's a massive buff to it. Not only does it do way more damage, but it lasts, I don't know, probably twice as long off the top of my head. Like, Master Collection Fire Wheels is a massive step up from... Oh my god, I just got shredded. But yeah, whereas in the Vita version, you can choose to just not do the little minigame to make it more powerful. Which there's not really any reason to not do. Yeah, you can. On the Vita, when you do Nimpo. You know the whole, like, shake the controller to make Nimpo more powerful that was in the PS3 version? On the Vita, you get, like, a little mini-game on the back touch panel, and you just have to, you know, press buttons in a certain way. And it makes the Nimpo more powerful. So. And that was kind of their way of like, carrying that over, I guess, from the PS3. Whereas in the Master Collection, you know, it's... the Nimpos just defaulted to the damage boosted version every time. Rescue you when I killed this boat. See, like that didn't hit any of them, and yet they flew like right over my line of fire. Yeah. I didn't notice, but this must have had an enemy, an ammo count somewhere, because I was actually out of bullets at the end. Yeah, they do that in Modern Warfare too. In the first Modern Warfare, you pretty much spend half the game just throwing grenades back at enemies. The last few months on Okinawa have taken their toll. Morale is low. It's the rain, sir. And the mud. Tanks are getting bogged down. Supplies aren't getting. What's a wig? We can't even get the wounded out. Yes, sir. Understood.
We're moving out. What's the skinny? Major Gordon's ordered another attack on the enemy stronghold beyond this ridge.
Any word on supplies?
They're coming.
Hey, flamethrower.
Just get up the hill, Polanski.
Flamethrower is a lot of fun in this. Right, did that just blow his leg off? My god, you guys are useless. Oh, I do love dismemberment in shooters. It's a shame you don't see it much anymore. Can I not get that from them? Fuck, that's right next to me. Oh, my bad. Uh-oh. Oh, fuck. Yeah, can I get back up here? Alright, don't kill that guy this time. Yeah, it's really bad. It's just, I don't know why, it just seems to be way worse than normal in this game. You can have like four or five enemies, four or five friendlies just stare at an enemy and not shoot them. It's pretty ridiculous. Oh, see what I mean? Like, my entire squad is behind me there, and they cannot kill one fucking guy. Just... ugh. I've heard this is the worst one. And so far, like... I guess just going by some of the missions here. Yeah. I'm not even going to bother playing this on Veteran. Like, it just does not look fun at all. Yeah, I would if I could rely on you fuckers to shoot anybody. Whoops. There we go. Oh, fuck. Did the Frontline have a mission on that as well? I think it did, right? Frontline had a D-Day mission, I think. You know, I was just about to say, I'm surprised they haven't remade Modern Warfare. I'm surprised they haven't done like a remake of Medal of Honor, but then I forget they tried to relaunch Medal of Honor and it just completely bombed because it was just so bad. Anybody remember that trailer, the announcement trailer for the new Medal of Honor? Oh shit. They did do two of them, if I remember rightly. I think they did do a sequel. Oh, is this okay? I think there's someone in that. There's someone in the trees here as well. Throw my grenade back at me. Oh, for God. I keep forgetting that there's guys in the trees, isn't there? There's guys in the trees. Yeah, this is PS3. Oh shit. Fuck it, I knew it. I think the other side was probably better, though. Oh shit, fuck you. I mean, look at all these green dots here, and yet, like, you guys are just absolutely, like, useless is an understatement. Hello. Shut up, Jack Bauer. There we go. You need to kill something to tell me what to do. That was my fault. That was stupid. I really thought they would at least kill, like, the first couple of guys there, but yeah, of course. Oh, we actually got a checkpoint there, that's nice. Is there a penalty for actually killing these? Whoops. doesn't look like you can. That's weird, though, because I have actually killed them, like, on accident a couple of times. The thing is that, like, they don't even serve that purpose, because the enemies don't shoot at them. Like, you know, the enemies only ever target you. So, you know how in some... Like, in Gears of War, your AI is pretty shit in that game. But at least the enemies will actually shoot at them. Like, you know, they can distract them sometimes. Whereas in this, like, they don't even do that. Okay, I need another weapon. There we go. Another one there, look. See? But they did kill one guy, so I'll take that. Oh. How many fucking shots is it going to take to kill him? Yeah, they do. And they can body block too, which is very useful. I wonder if we're going to get a Gears 6 reveal in June. I would be interested to see what that's going to be. I don't really have high hopes for it, though. I was really surprised that barrel didn't kill them, though. What do we do now? Keep moving, Velocity. Let's go. Our tanks are moving up. Convoy won't be far behind. Whoops, that was weird. Really need something with more ammo. Well, I was lucky. Ow. Yeah, I mean, I don't mind what they did with Gears 4 onwards. It's just they're just not as good. But I'm still curious what they'll do with it going forward. I wonder if they'll carry on the story that they set up in Gears 5, because the story they set up in 5 is pretty big, and I really feel I would not be surprised if they just go the Halo Infinite way and just do like a soft reboot with Gears 6, which is really shit. You would like to think they'd have learnt their lesson from Halo Infinite, but we'll see. Where the hell did you come from? Oh, Guns for show, knives for a pro. How did that not, like, how did that not hit him? This doesn't feel like... Well, okay. Yeah, so do I, but I really wouldn't be surprised if they did. How that, like, okay. But yeah, it's not... It doesn't bode well. Gears 6. Say, that game... I mean, there was also that stuff a little while ago about all sorts of, like, development trouble with that game, which is just, you know, when a game like that, you know, that scale, you haven't seen anything in so long, it's just not good. And apparently, a big chunk of the Coalition had to help with Infinite. So... Who knows, you know, how that impacted the actual games. Almost got yourself shot there, sir. Okay, yeah, I have just circled around here. I don't know. I think with Halo in particular, I think it was kind of just the perfect storm of everything. But I mean, it's, and I mentioned this before about it. Who the fuck is shooting me? Yeah, I mentioned this about again with them, is that it's annoying that, like, when people try and excuse that, and you think, you know, you, at the end of the day, like, you have all the money in the world behind this game, you know, that's not an excuse, like, that doesn't absolve them of, what's the word, whoops, that's not good. Ah, crap, I haven't got any left. Sure, I need to go here. But we'll see. At least, hopefully with, okay, so they're my dudes. At least, hopefully with Gears, they haven't got the problem of having to reset the entire game like they kind of had with Infinite. My god, are you feeling alright? He actually killed somebody. I was hoping they'd all have that. Well, yeah, but that's my point, you know. Like, it's still the excuses, like the excuses people make for Infinite. Oh my god, just drive me crazy. You know, they're like, oh well, you know, it's bad management, blah 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 blah. You think, yeah, so, like, that makes it worse, you know. It's not a resources problem, it's just, like, that's kind of what's so bad about it, is that, you know, it's not a resources problem, it's just complete incompetence. It is complete and utter ineptitude. And, you know, that's something that, I mean, it is very strange, though, because it makes you wonder, like, what's the involvement of, it makes you wonder, like, what the involvement level is of the higher-ups, because... At some point or another, you would like to think that the more powerful people at Microsoft would you know, would say, okay, right, what, you know, what, like, just what the fuck have you guys been doing for the past 5 years? And when they tell them, oh yeah, I don't know, bro, game development, son, you'd think that they would say, okay, right, you're all fired. We need to actually get people in here and know what the fuck they're doing. Because I remember there was that thing that came out a little while ago when someone, I think someone left 343. And it made the rounds where they said, oh yeah, we pitched Microsoft, you know, all these... Look at this, just shooting the ceiling. Like, when they said, oh yeah, we pitched Microsoft all these new ideas for Halo and, you know, the, like... What's the word? The implication being that, like, oh, you know, those boring executives, like, wouldn't let us branch out. And I think, yeah, probably because they thought, you guys haven't managed to deliver, you know, a really good Halo game yet, you know, where when the blueprint for doing so exists. So, you know, make one of those first, and then you can branch out. But first, you need to actually, you know, deliver on just making a really good Halo game, which you haven't done yet. So, it's easy to, you know, come out with stuff like that and just blame the man. But when the man is the one paying your bills and, you know, paying you to do something that you haven't managed to pull off in almost 12 years, you can't blame them for saying, no. You know, we're not actually gonna, you know, we're not actually gonna put, you know, shitloads more money into some wacky idea you have when you can't even do a Halo game right. There's definitely scope to do more with, you know, the Halo setting, but every day we spent crawling through the mud and the dirt, our bullets whistle all around. But this is the last time we're gonna have to put our lives on the line. This is the enemy's last chance. When we take Shuri Castle, we go home, all of us. Yeah, and didn't they scrap their new engine as well, I think? I remember reading something about that. Not that long ago. I think they did end up actually moving away from the new engine. But that, you know, that's all, you know, that all comes down to the same point. You know, at some stage, those decisions were green lit. And they said, yeah, we'll do this. And they just didn't do it. I know I sound pretty harsh, but I do have absolutely no sympathy for 343 on this. They haven't even managed to, like, I think overall, like, the single best game they've made across the board. Oh dear. What the hell? Oh. Okay, probably not the gun for that. Okay, go away. Hang on. I'll keep that sniper rifle. There's probably a reason they gave me one, so. Oh, is it? Okay, yeah, so it's just the old engine. But yeah, so I know I sound harsh when it comes to them, but I think that overall, like, their most solid game to this date is still Halo 4. And that's not much of a compliment, because Halo 4, like, while Halo 4 is solid, it's not even close to being on par with, you know, the previous Halo games. And they've had, and it was a, you know, a decent first effort, but, you know, I think they've had a lot of time to make another one and improve on it, and they've done it in some ways, but not in others. Like, Halo 5 on launch was a bit of a train wreck. But then by the time the game wrapped, like, Halo 5 multiplayer was top notch. But then they, like, all of that just went out of the window for Infinite. Like, they had an unlock, like, they had an unlock system that was actually good. And then they thought, oh yeah, you know this system we have that is very well liked amongst the community and everyone enjoys it? Yeah, we're just going to completely get rid of that for the next game, and we're just going to make you pay for armor colors. I'm sure people will love that. And again, you know, that decision got the green light. It was like, yeah, okay, cool. So when they come out with, you know, all their, like, you know, excuses. It's like, nah, you know. It's just be quiet. You fucked up. At least admit that. Just me or enemies seem to take a lot more bullets to die in this game. Oh, shit. That, oh my god. Hang on, buddy, I'll help you out. Jesus. Are you missing a word there? Do you mean fun multiplayer? It did, but Halo 5 multiplayer at launch was a bit, you know, at launch, it was a bit ropey. It was a bit rocky at launch. You only had, what was it? There was only like 4 playlists at launch. There was only ranked, like no social at all. I think Breakout, although I'm one of the people, I did actually quite like Breakout. I thought that was a really fun mode. But it's not really like what most people want to play Halo with. But that was one of like the core ranked playlists. It did take them a few months to get Halo 5 multiplayer, you know, to kind of where it was actually, you could say, yeah, this is actually pretty decent. And then you had Firefight later on. I think Firefight is in Infinite, but I've not actually played it yet. But Firefight in Halo 5 was fucking brilliant. It was really good. And I've mentioned this before, but like the unlock system when it launched was a bit like, I don't know about that. But then they made the unlock system way better. You could just get, like, you could easily get everything without having to pay anything. And then in the next game, you know, they are literally charging you, like, what was it, at launch for Infinite? Like, an armor set, like an armor color was like £15 or something. It was, like, you know, So as I said, yeah, when they come out with the, oh, well, we just, you know, all the bollocks they come out with, it's like, man, no, you know, you, somewhere, someone approved of this, and you thought people would tolerate it, and when they, you know, said, go fuck yourself, you tried to play sympathy, and it's like, ah, come on, man. Yeah, I mean, that the whole thing with, like, paying for customization, though, that's, I feel like the entire industry now is just, oh. That prompt really doesn't seem to make sense. I press R3 right when it comes up, and yet I die. But yeah, the whole customization thing, I mean, look at Tekken 8. Tekken 8's kind of experiencing that right now. That's what 10 years of people, you know, paying for customization stuff will do. Now it's just the expected, which is really shit. You don't unlock anything in games anymore. My god, thank you. It's like, you want to unlock a costume? Give us money. You want to unlock, you know, anything? Give us money. You want to unlock that, like, you want to use the costume that you had in this game? Give us money. Everything is just, give us money. And it's about time that people, you know, the general audience as well has started to kind of be like, okay, this is too much, you know. This is ridiculous. Because it's the general audience that you need to say this is fucked. As long as it's just people that watch YouTube and Twitch saying it's fucked, that, like, that's not enough. They don't make up the majority of the customer base. You need the Johnny Buttons of the world to say, fuck you, I'm not paying £10 for a fatality. You know, get the fuck out of here with that. You need just the people who play Tekken to just mash buttons with Panda to be like, no, I'm not paying, you know, a fiver for a hat. So, I mean, here's the thing, like, you can't really, like, lay the blame at one person's, you know, feet, but if we're talking Infinite, like, it's everyone involved, you know, it's management at 343, it's the shot callers at Microsoft, It's the QA, like the QA department. I don't mean the QA as in the game. I mean the QA as in like their internal QA of, you know, we have a schedule and we want to have, you know, we have goals and we have these things met. You know, those were probably never met with that game, and you need to have things in place to deal with that, and they obviously didn't. The fact that Halo Infinite was, I mean, think about this, right? Think about this. Imagine this alternate history for a second here, where, you know, when they showed the initial reveal trailer for Infinite, that very first trailer with Craig, the Brute, imagine if they didn't delay that game and they just released it 3 months later. Can you imagine this? It would actually almost have been funny if they did. You imagine the state that game must have actually been in, and yet someone either said, yep, this is okay, we can launch this game in 3 weeks, 3 months, sorry. Or they said, you know what, this is totally fucked, let's put out a trailer anyway, and when people blow it up, we'll say, we have listened to the fans, and we're going to delay the game, you see, we care about you. Then to only release the game a year later and have it still be, like, you know, a fucking train wreck. So, I don't know, man. Always end up talking about Infinite at some point, but there is probably a book or a series of books that can be written on, you know, how that game ended up being so fucked up. Again, you know, despite having all the resources in the world to make it. You know, if it was a small studio, you could understand it. But, you know, a studio of that size and of that experience, you think, man, you guys just have no excuse. So. Well, I mean, because people pay it. That's why, man, people pay it. I was watching, oh crap. Oh, you fucker. I was watching, the main man had a video on this yesterday, I think, and it was about the shop, like the state of the shop in Tekken 8. And he said something that I think a lot of people do make this mistake, honestly. They think that the only people that pay for this stuff are the quote-unquote whales of the industry. And you think, no, it's really not. It's the everyman just doesn't care that much. Like, for instance, when they started putting in, like, Capcom are pretty good at doing this. They put stuff in the game, like in the Resident Evil remakes, you can just buy the infinite rocket launcher. You can just buy it. Like, and people say, oh, you know, it's the whales that are buying that stuff. It's like, it's not, it's the everyman that's buying it. The only thing is now it's getting too expensive for them. Because the average Johnny Buttons is not gonna complete professional, you know, in under 2 hours or whatever on Resident Evil. They're just going to pay, you know, £2 to buy the rocket launcher. Like, do you think, to the average person, like, you can pay £2 for the infinite rocket launcher, or you can, you know, complete a very, very hard challenge that you're not going to spend the time to do, or you could pay £2 and have the infinite rocket launcher and just play through with that and have fun. They're just going to pay the £2. The problem is that now they're starting to get to the point where, you know, the stuff that used to be £2 is now 10, and even and the people that used to be like, oh yeah, £2, sure, I'll pay £2, why not? That's not a lot. Now those people, the same people, like, whoa, 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 a tenner? You know, I'm not paying that. I think that's the mistake there. Like, they're getting too greedy now. They're getting way too greedy. Who said that? Again, dude, I don't get that. I'm pressing it. Maybe you have to press it way earlier. Oh yeah, fatality tokens were definitely the litmus test for that shit. And they're another thing that people say, oh, you know, who would pay for fatality tokens? You can just go online and look them up. And you think, yeah. Like, shoutouts to Big D for this phrase, man. The Johnny Buttons, how much were fatality tokens in like, MKX? They were super cheap, I think. They're just going to pay for one-button fatalities, because all they care about is fatalitying, like, their friend when they come over to play. They don't give a fuck about, you know, it's like, oh, I downloaded an FAQ with all the fatalities. They're not going to do that. Yeah, you could. Yeah, DMC. I think DMC 4 Special Edition was the first to do that, if I remember rightly. You could just buy like a, you could just buy a shitload of red orbs. You could buy a load of Proud Souls, so you could just upgrade your character, like, you know, instantly from the very beginning. And again, in a game like that, where the choice is, you know, play the game 3 or 4 times, and for the average person, they're, you know, they're pretty hard. Or you can just give us, you know, a couple of quid, and you can just get all this stuff now. As someone who, tried to do the crypt normally in MKX, when the crypt was on sale for like 12 quid, and this is someone I used to compete in that game, I kind of wish I'd have just paid the 12 quid and unlocked the crypt, because I never finished unlocking the crypt, even though I played that game for thousands of hours. So, but yeah, I'll say that the issue now, like, they're just getting way too greedy, and they're pissing off the people who actually buy this shit. Which is good, because then, you know, we might actually see a change. I was hoping I'd get more ammo in that. Yeah, you did, yeah. I mean, look at MK11, man. Oh my days. MK11 is sad, what's happened to that game. I still say, you know, the core game is good. The core, oh shit, the core fighting game, you know, underneath all the bullshit of MK1 is a good game. But they're just, you know, everything else about that game is just, you know, just so bad. Oh, is that like a box of ammo? That's cool. That's a nice little touch, actually. Oh, come on, one of you's got to have a... Hey, there we go, I say, one of you's got to have a machine gun. Like, yeah, it does take a long time. It really does. And I think, yeah, when you get people that, you know, would rather just pay money for it, like, that's the problem. Because some of the stuff that I've seen in the Tekken 8 shop, oh my god, man. You know, that they're selling you, you know, 3-game-old costumes for like 10 quid, and you think, Jesus, man. I mean, you think the game itself costs 80 or 70, you know? They're charging you 1/6 of the game's price for a costume. That, you know, that they didn't do anything to actually do. You know, they're just, you know, they're just like cutting and pasting something from an old game and charging you, you know, 1/6 of the game's price to buy it. It's, I mean, at least people are saying, you know, yo, this is too much. I wonder what GTA 6 is going to be like. Yeah, there is a battle pass in Tekken 8. There is. I wonder what they're going to do with GTA 6. Because that game has some mighty big shoes to fill. So. In terms of just money above everything else. Sure. You know, I saw I saw a really good quote recently that summed it up like that, that summed it up really well, and it was something like, you know, games used to be, you know, like a fun pastime. You know, they used to be something you did as a hobby to just chill and relax, and now they feel like a chore. to some extent. And I think, you know, depending on the game or depending on what kind of games you like, that can definitely be true. But then you just have to pick your, you just have to pick what games you play. Because, sometimes you just, I mean, like, GTA is a good example, you know? I haven't played GTA since Vice City. I have no desire to go back to San Andreas, because that is, that game just wasn't really that fun to me. So I think, yeah, okay, cool. I guess that means I just, if I want to play GTA now, I'll play the old ones. And, you know, while that sucks, because, you know, it's nice to play new stuff, what can you do? I miss playing shooters, like online shooters, I do. But just, most of them are just not fun. You know, they are designed that way. They are designed to not be fun unless you, like, pay more money. And I think, well, I don't want to do that. So, I just won't play. No. The last exception to that was Halo 5. And there's plenty of people that say, like, you had to pay in Halo 5, which is complete bullshit, but, you know. I think the only people who say that are people who didn't actually play Halo 5. Because, and I guess people don't care enough to do it, but you could make a video about the rec system and how to actually make a good progressive unlocking system that you didn't have to pay money for. It's just that, you know, that Halo 5 is dead now, so no one cares. Although you can still find firefight games, funnily enough. When I still had Xbox Live, I would always, every now and then I'd check on that. And it's like, oh, you can still, like, people are still playing Firefight. Go away. I blame World of Warcraft. Well, yeah. If you want to go back to the very beginning, yeah. I saw a video lately, actually, that was a kind of a retrospective on Bethesda and... Oh, no, not Bethesda. Not... Who am I? Blizzard. That's it. Blizzard. Yeah, and they mentioned World of Warcraft. And, you know, they thought when that game launched, you know, they had how many people paying, like, £15 a month to play it? And as soon as that happened, that was kind of the turning point. Like, every other publisher looked at that and thought, yo, we need that. How can we make one of those? So. No, it didn't. Halo 5's unlocks at launch were not great, though. Like, that's, you know, that's fair. But after the first, like, two patches, like, man, like, you are constantly unlocking stuff in that game. Constantly. I remember I got, I think I got a legendary unlocks once in like, a daily login pack, and I thought, yo, thank you, I'll take that. And you could pay for stuff if you wanted to. But you didn't, but the thing is, like, you didn't have to, you know? You could easily unlock everything just by playing. Okay, there's a lot of barrels in here, I've got to be careful. But yeah, you know, like, charging money just for a different color on your armor is just like, fucking hell, dude. How far we have fallen. Yeah, there was someone on, I used to still be on the Waypoint forums back then, and there was a couple of people that made a thread about, yeah, fuck it, I just paid $2,000 to unlock everything in the rec store system, and you think, fucking hell. Okay. You know, it's your money at the end of the day, but, you know, just for frame of reference, when I started playing Halo 5, and this was before the rec pack system changes were implemented, it took me, I think, about 5 months, maybe 5 or 6 months to unlock everything in the game. And that was, I mean, I played probably every day, but, you know, I wasn't living on the game 24/7, you know. So, someone that, you know, works full-time, and I was traveling to work then as well, like, I had a very active day. I spent maybe, I don't know, like an average an hour a day maybe playing it, and I unlocked everything in 5-6 months. I didn't have to live on the game for a year to unlock everything. So, Oh yeah, when they launched, they were. I mean, because when they launched, I don't know if you might not remember or you might not know. I don't know. But when they launched, all the emblems and I think all the I think it was all the emblems and there was something else, but everything was included in the unlock system. And there was something like 600 emblems or something. So people worked out, you know, you'd have to go through, you know, X amount of silver rec packs, like, just to get all the emblems unlocked. But then, pretty soon after the game launched, they took the emblems out of that system. Which was a really good decision. Because then you just unlocked the stuff you wanted. You know, you unlocked weapons, you unlocked armors, you unlocked assassinations, all that stuff. You unlocked all the good shit. The emblems never should have been in that system. But I think that's another case where, you know, they tried to push it as far as they could. They thought, you know what, fuck it, we'll try putting the emblems in here and see if people complain about it. Everyone complained about it, so they took it out. And again, that's kind of the other side to that thing, right? You know, it's like they take the piss. They try and take the piss, and then they apologize for taking the piss. It's like, you know, they shit in your garden. You know, they take a shit in your garden, and they're like, oh, I didn't realize that would offend you, I'm sorry. And you're like, you could have just not done it in the first place. You could have just not done the thing that you pretty much knew most people wouldn't like. But that's the thing that is so annoying now. Like, they try and get away with it. You know, the phrase, you know, don't piss on me and tell me it's raining, comes to mind. And I feel like that's what so many companies do these days. They try and gouge the fuck out of you. And then when people say, no, this is not okay, they say, oh, you know, we have listened to the community, and we hear you, and we want your feedback. It's like, you could just not have done the super shady thing to begin with. And then you wouldn't have to apologize. I do feel bad for the people that spent that money, though, in Halo 5. Because, again, if they'd have waited just, like, a month, you know, all that stuff, you know, they would have been able to unlock all that stuff anyway, so they literally would have had it for free. I mean, there were people that were pissed about that, don't get me wrong. So, yeah, exactly, yeah. Like, we're sorry, please forgive us, and then they do the exact same thing again in the next game. And you think, yeah, cool. Games as a service, man. It's pretty crazy when you think about the series that's buried. I mean, think about it, you know, Halo, let's be serious here. For all intents and purposes, Halo is actually dead. Like, it's so bad that they managed to kill Halo. That's pretty fucked when you really think about it. You're like, man, you did it. You actually managed to kill Halo with all this bullshit. It's, you think, wow, like, well done, guys. I always think back to that line in the first Kill Bill when he's at the crime scene and he says, if you were a moron, you could almost admire it. And you think, yeah. No game killed Halo. You know, Call of Duty, Medal of Honor, Killzone, it was like no game killed Halo. It was the developers themselves. I can already just imagine how just pure cancer this bit's gonna be on veteran, so fuck that. Which it makes me think, you know, what are they going to do with what are they gonna do with GTA 6? Cause they are gonna be fucking ruthless when that game launches. Oh, there we go. I wouldn't say Halo's been dead for a long time. It's been in trouble for a long time, but it's like But it's Halo has not been in the, like, you think of the state Halo is in now. It's actually fucking tragic. So yeah, you guys just aren't gonna fucking shoot anyone, are you? Go away. Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. It's like, you get into a car. If you want to drive this car, it's like, you hijack a car. If you want to hijack this car, that's a battle pass. You can only drive the car if you if you pay us money. I mean, I'm joking, but I mean, like, you go to a pay and spray, and you actually have to pay real money to like get the police off you. Man, I shouldn't say shit like that. I would give them ideas. Someone from Take Two might be listening and thinking, "Yo, that's a great idea. Let's do that." It's like, you actually have to pay us money, real money, to lose your wanted level. Or the game is impossible. Right, so do I need to, like, hit the building? Oh my god, stop doing that. Could do with some more... I really could do with some more machine gun ammo. There we go. Again, I mean, there's a great clip on the Giant Bombcast from years ago, before Gears Judgment came out, and it's of Jeff jokingly saying, "Well, man, you know, imagine if in the next Gears game, it only has like 4 maps on launch or something, and then they want to charge you for any more maps, and then Gears Judgment comes out and is exactly that," and you think, "Oh God, you know, shit, you know." They will try, you know, some pretty shady shit. And if they can get away, like, you give them an inch, they will take a mile. Oh, fuck. That was close. What's up, Paul Allen? You'll have to pay hospital bills with real money. Again, dude, don't give them ideas. We're saying this as a joke, and then GTA 6 comes out, and then, you know, you have to pay your medical bills with real money. It's, oh god, yeah. I mean, there's so many videos out there as well, when you think about it, of, you think how many maps, on average, shooters used to launch with. You know, it wasn't uncommon for a shooter to launch with, like, a dozen maps. Now they come out with 6. Or 7. And then, you know, and there's maps for sale day one. And you think, wait, you know, no. This is backwards. This used to be, you know, things used to be better than this. And it's not rose-tinted glasses. That's the one good thing about, you know, I guess that's the one good thing about the enthusiast part is that, you know, there are people who will actually go back and look at this shit, and they're like, no, you know, this wasn't just in our heads. You know, you did used to get more shit. Nice, what's up, Wolf? You have to buy a real... Oh my... Yeah, dude, again, don't give them ideas. Don't give them ideas, man. Many of things said in jest and all that. We go home. All of us. I could see it happening.
The Red Army encircles the Reichstag, their parliament building and final stronghold of the fascist Reich. In the surrounding streets, we choke the life from those who were still there to defend it. play a part in this glorious battle. When our flag flies over the city, our enemies' defeat and humiliation will be beyond question. Our vengeance will be complete.
Yeah, that's true, actually. Yeah, that's a very common tactic, isn't it? Yeah. I mean, Halo 5 was guilty of that, to be fair. It was. They included Warzone maps in the map count. And you think, ah, come on. You can only play these in Warzone. You know, they don't count. And they split up the Warzone maps as well, you know, for, like, Warzone Assault. Although, Halo 5, although, that said, though, having said that, the whole number of maps is an annoying thing to focus on, because when games have tons of maps, but, you know, half of them are shit, and you never ever want to play them, and everyone just vetoes them, you think, okay, cool. I'd rather have 8 maps where all 8 of them are really good than have 12 and 6 of them are shit. What's up, dogs? Well, it's not necessarily DLC, it's more, like, DLC is part of it, but it's repeat revenue, that's what they want. They don't want to, and a lot of companies have, you know, come out and said this, you know, they don't want to, the model of just putting out a game and having people buy the game, compared to, you know, buy the game, and then in a couple of months, buy some DLC, have a shop where you can buy extra shit, a couple of months later, have some more DLC, have a battle pass, like, they just want repeat business out of you. They want people to keep dumping money into shit. Whoa, fuck me. I mean, this came up a couple of streams ago, but do you guys remember season passes and online passes? Do you remember those? They kind of, they didn't stick around very long. But I think they just took other forms, you know. Now, season passes are just battle passes. Online passes are just, like, included in, you know, your first lot of DLC that kind of, you know, is all stuff that's, you know, in the game anyway. It's... the actual things have gone away, but they're just charging you in different ways for them. What game was I looking at the other day that had an online pass? It was an old game. Well, I say old, it wasn't that old. I think it was The Darkness 2. Let me check. I have, yeah, because it was on my shelf. Yeah, so here's The Darkness 2. My limited edition copy. Which comes with a pretty cool poster. I actually forgot about that. I'm going to get that framed. It's actually a pretty sick poster. Yeah, here we are. Where's the online pass thing in here? It was in here somewhere. Maybe not. It might not have been The Darkness too, actually. Oh, no. Here it is. Yep. Here we are. So, this has... what is it? This has something in here for buying a new copy. What's it called? This isn't really called anything. It's just called, like... it's just, hey, look. Go and grab your free shit for buying a new copy. But yeah. You know, that was a really common thing towards the tail end of that generation. Because they really, really did not want you buying used games. And they got people kind of into that now where... I mean, remember when the PS4 was on the horizon? And they made a huge deal about saying that, you know, day one digital stuff was going to be like the same price and yada, yada, yada. The price creep on new games over the past generation and a bit has been fucking insane. I saw a post a couple of days ago that Stellar Blade was discounted on for pre-order by 20%. So it was 20% off the pre-order, and the digital version was still £52. Because the default price is now 70. And for a little while, you know, that wasn't the case. You can get, you know, if you buy physical... Most stores now, at least in the UK, like, they're around 50. You know, stuff being £20 more expensive for physical, like, that's fucking outrageous. And yet people have just gotten used to it. And then you've got the next level of that argument is, well, you know, if everything is digital, you know, do you really own it? Oh, you motherfucker. That was bad timing. There's a, I watched a video early this morning, actually, on YouTube from Mr. Who's the Boss, and he had a video, and he basically just kind of went over this entire thing and how shitty it's all becoming. And I thought, yeah, it's a shame that the, like, most people that see that will be people that already know. Like, he's I feel like a lot of it, he's just preaching to the converted. Man, you guys really are, like... These really are setting a new standard here, man, for, like, terrible AI. Keeping an eye out for Hail Mary grenades. As long as I keep getting ammo for this, I'm fine, really. I had a feeling that was gonna happen. The last mission. Motherfucker. My God. You know, one thing I'm really happy that's not in this game is that if you shoot an enemy, like, if you shoot a friendly, it's you fail. Because it's so easy to shoot, like, your own people. Oh my God, do these guys just keep respawning? Motherfucker. All you did there was steal my cover. You were not of any assistance whatsoever. Answer my question, was there a mid-checkpoint there? There was not. Can I shoot through here? Okay. I think I can, but... My God. Where did he come from? What the? I love that. Like, there's not even a gun there. It's literally just bullets coming out of a wall. What are you doing? Wait. Oh my God. Was that? I think that was an ally there that just. Someone up there again. Yeah, I'm not sure if this is the last mission. It kind of feels like it. I'm actually running out of ammo. No, I'm it back. Move! Are they? Yeah, they're my dudes. He's not. Right. You know, yeah, that's a good point actually, yeah. Okay, I shot him. That was garbage. I was really afraid that was gonna happen. Right, okay, he's dead. Man, I swear the damage indicators just make up their mind. Because where it says you're getting shot from, and then you turn, and there's just nothing there. Right. Fuck you. Oh no, I did not want that. I'm very aware of how bad of a strategy this is, by the way. Because, you know, leaving anything to the friendly AI is stupid. It's just, you know, I've got to try and kill as many things as I can. Quickly. Because they don't do fuck all. Right, there's got to be a machine gun on here. Here we go. Give me that. There we go. What? Dude. Ah, that was unlucky. Ow. Okay, that did not go well. I think it must have been there, and I just walked back onto it. Right, fuck you. Right. I mean, look how many there are here, and like the. That grenade's very close. Okay, I don't have a lot of ammo in that. Okay, that's...
I
Are these... Let me just keep respawning. Oh, shit. Okay, there we are. What the... What the hell? Do I have to back off then? Like, he was nowhere near me. And again, I fucking shot him. This copy was £2.50, by the way. This was in my recent raid. I love getting games that cheap. It's just great. Although the update, for some reason, like, when you try and update this game, it just completely breaks. It just, oh, there was two of them. Yeah, when I try and update this, it just crashes on the update, and it just stops, and so I don't know what's going on there. Why do my grenades take 100 years to explode? Oh no, please pick up the right gun. Alright. Okay, I really don't get what's going on here with this flamethrower guy. Okay, right. Okay. Cool. Man, look at that dude. He just walked through stone. What a god. Okay, I'm guessing that wasn't the last mission, then. Yeah, it's pretty nuts, man. Hard to very hard is a significant jump. Enemies do roughly probably twice as much damage and have maybe not twice as much health, but they have a lot more health. And enemies are way more grab happy as well. Enemies guard break a lot more, too. Yeah, that's true, actually. I just don't use my 360 much anymore. My PS3 is still, you know, used on the regular, whereas other than my modded 360, I really don't use the 360 that much these days. Alright, well, I'm getting pretty hungry, so I'm going to go grab some lunch, I think. This might be the last mission, going by the name of the mission and the date. I feel like this might be the last one. I might try that RE4 run later as well. I'm curious to see if that run's possible. Alright. And I haven't played RE4 in so long. I feel like it's been years since I played OG RE4. Which I don't think it has actually been that long. It just feels like a long time. So I might play that later. Very chilled day today. Boom. Alright guys, what's going to do it for me? I'm going to go grab some lunch. I'm a bit peckish. And, we'll probably be back a bit later. Probably not anybody on, is there? Nah. Sunday's a fairly quiet day, isn't it? So. Yeah, pretty much. Everyone's doing something. How dare they? Anyway, dudes. I will catch you all later. We'll be back for some RE4. And have a good afternoon. Peace.